Just a quick one on how you're supposed to do ropes properly. Usually on ropes of this size, on the ships and things like that, my dad was a marine, Royal Marine, in the based in Chatham in Kent in the UK, and he showed me quite a few different knots. That's the top of the knot, the loop, the end knot with the crown knot on the end of it, and how to join ropes using this method. And you'll notice on there that that's been whipped with a smaller piece of string. Unfortunately, this is synthetic string. This is hemp rope, by the way, not the drug, but probably from the same plant. You can tell that it's a rope as such, or natural rope, because the natural fibres coming off the side. You could just get a lighter and trim them off, just melt them down. That's the way to finish the rope off. If you're going to start doing this sort of knotting work, you'll notice that these sort of ropes, they fray quite easily. This one's synthetic, and you can barely melt the end to keep them together. If you're doing it on a natural fibre rope, then each of the three ends you'll whip with a small piece of string or some good strong cotton. That keeps the end together. That means that you can do your threading through quite happily. Then when you get to the end of it, you cut all your ends off, leave just the smallest tan on there, and then start from one end, whip that round. If you don't know how to do whipping, then look it up. It's quite a simple process. Basically, you put a loop of string through, wind it all the way around, covering that loop of string. When you get to the end, put the end through and pull the tail, and that pulls the string back into the end, and that keeps it nice and tight. To further enhance that, on the really old ships, you might cover that in tar, just to stop that from getting worn and coming apart. But that is a very strong method of making a loop in the end of a rope. I've quite easily to tow a car on that.